Welcome back to Nova Aetas. This is Arcade Night. And guys, today we are so close. We are finishing the aqueduct today. Also, I need to get some new companions because I have big plans for the future. We're going to go finish that aqueduct. And also, we're going to talk about where we now believe Rodrick Reddmond should start his new kingdom, because it's not going to be in Raviden. At least I don't believe so at this moment. And also, guys, I am going to get a new helmet because I believe this helmet is bad luck. I'm done with it. Too much bad luck for Rodrick Reddmond lately. And so we're going to take care of that in today's episode. But first of all, I'm going to take a sip of my tasty beverage. So comforting in these times of need for Rodrick Reddmond. But first of all, I have seen there's a couple of companions that I am interested in recruiting. And one of them is this guy, Eric the Navigator. And I have spoken with him before. Yes, yes, I will use you in my company. But he is a noble, which is good news for me. And you know what? Money's not a big deal. Money's not a big deal to me. That's fine. I will take care of you. All right. And then also there's this one guy, Taryn. Here's to the doom and downfall of all Harborn lords and ladies. What? I don't think so, good sir. I don't think so, good sir. So I have... Let's see if I can get a caravan guard. One of you. Sure. All right. So my party is full. Let's also go to the tavern. Not the tavern. The marketplace. And I believe I just need, what? Two more tools. Let's see. That's a good price on a tool. And... That's a good price on a tool. Let me pick up some food while I'm here. Anything good? Grapes. Grapes is good. My men love grapes. What else can I get? Let's just get some grain, some bread. A few things so I don't have to worry about them for a while. Okay. Let's get out of here. All right. So I'm in good shape. I've got a full party. I've recruited back up. And I've got this new guy, Eric the Navigator. Tell me about your skills. So you're level 5. So you've got 2 in leadership. You've got some horse archery. 2 in riding. Strength and agility of 9. None in firearms. So you're old school, I assume. What equipment do you have? So you do need a horse. Let's see. What kind of horse can it give you? Sway back, speed of 35. Let's give you that one. And you have a decent sword. I'm not going to give you the Sword of Harless. I did replace my sword. This is a much better sword than the Sword of Harless. Swing 43. And look at that. The reach of 95, speed of 102 compared to this. Look at the swing difference. Much more powerful. So I need to get you some better gear. But until then, that shall work for you, good sir. And let's move Catherine up to the Loyal Guard as well. She's come back to my party recently. And where? There you are. Move you to the Loyal Guard. Move you up. We'll see how you work out, good sir. Okay, so let's head back to Raviden because I'm ready to complete the construction of the aqueducts. And I'm ready to see what's going to happen. Rodrick Reddmond is tired of being just a... It seems like a mere peasant in the eyes of everyone else in this kingdom. Definitely the Agonic Order. No one gives a damn. No one gives a damn! Apparently money means nothing. Your opinion is noted, but I don't even care to hear what you have to say. You fall back in line. You shut the hell up. Alright, so I believe we have everything we need. All the tools we need to complete the construction of the Great Aqueduct. So let's do it. Let's do it. Okay, let's restore this. Okay, add the 10 tools. Oh my goodness, guys. I cannot. I'm so excited. Let's finish the construction. Congratulations, you finished restoring the Great Aqueduct. 15 prestige has been added. So is it complete? Please tell me. Oh, beautiful. Look at this. Look at this. It's gorgeous. Oh, it's so beautiful. Oh, I gotta take a sip to that. Gotta take a sip to that. Oh, that is wonderful. It makes me want to restore some more things in this godforsaken kingdom. But yeah, look, the statues are restored. Oh, so nice. So beautiful. Good work, Rodrick. Good work! Basically, the new world has paid for this. Completely paid for this. Alright, so we could come back and look at the beautiful work we've done. And one day we'll come back and we'll claim Ravenden so we can enjoy the aqueducts appropriately in our own kingdom. But for now, guys, we need to leave here. And we've got important business to do. Look at that. Look! Wow! That is amazing. That's really great. That is, yeah, you're welcome, Ravenden. You're welcome. Let's take a look at Ravenden. What's the garrison look like there anyway? God and God are still at war. Yeah, they're still loaded up. So I've been looking around, and I've been wondering exactly where could I start a kingdom? And I was thinking, just as I said, I want to start it off in, you know, a little corner of the world. And also, I thought it'd be cool to maybe go on a crusade. Oh, Swadia, this is actually perfect. This is actually perfect timing. This is actually perfect timing. So, now that the Agonic Order is at war with two kingdoms, I thought maybe taking, like, this town right here, Amirid, would be a good place to start. So I wanted to check out Amirid and see if the garrison is not too large. And the Agonic Order is at war with two factions now. Oh, well that... Man, this Turgon Horde, this is twice I've given him a shot. Once when we kind of rebooted when we had to go up to the next version of this mod. And they can't last for some reason. So I was thinking about taking a Mirrod. Because it's kind of out here on the outskirts of the kingdom. There's only 186 men. Granted, I'll have a hard time holding on to it. But then, if you look at, say, the notes, the faction notes, let's go to the Agonic Order. They have the least amount of vassals. They really do. Next, you go to the Serenid Sultanate. They have a fair amount of lords, but I think once I build up, once I grab a Mirrod and I make a couple of, say, Theowyn and Rolfin or Gregors lords on their own, then we can maybe do this, right? We can maybe do this. We can maybe make a go at it. So I'm going to think about this. I'm gonna cut away a little bit, give my army a little time to train up. I'm going to think about it for a little bit. You see, look at this. I'm so done. I'm so done with that little village, too. I couldn't even make it work to begin with. So I think that's what we're going to do. And then it gives me a chance to kind of expand out, and I could kind of have like a little desert kingdom, and I kind of like that idea. I really do. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to try that out, guys. I'm going to cut away. I'm going to try to make this work. And then when we come right back, we'll see if we are ready to siege Amirid or at least start our own little kingdom. So see you guys in a second. Guys, we're in the middle of a battle. When I left you, you won't believe this. The Agonic Order is now at war, not only with Swadia, not only with the Vingers, but also with the Serenids, and as I was leaving, an army of over 100 Serenids attacked us as I was trying to get out of this godforsaken kingdom. But we're going to have to, this is a great opportunity to kind of train up some men, and then from that, I'm going to go and ask to be released from the Agonic Order. And then we're going to go ahead and we're going to siege Amirid, because this is an opportunity we have to seize. The Agonic Order is at war with three kingdoms. I could go ahead and take Amirid, request the war to be over, and they'll probably accept it because they are at war with three different factions that are much stronger than they are. So, guys, we have a serious thing we need to do here. We need to take care of this battle quickly so we can get on with starting our kingdom. This is an opportunity that we just absolutely have to siege. Or seize, I should say, instead of siege. Oh, someone got hit. Oh, look at these men. We're gonna take you unawares. Go through them, man. Go through them. Cut through them. All right, I'm gonna send in my infantry too. And let's bring my archers closer. I think they're breaking. Yep. Oh, I think we got this, men. I think we got this. Oh, yeah. This was a fairly weak army. I can't believe they decided to come after us. Not a highly trained army. Well, there's one of my cavalry. That guy. Oh, you. All right, men. Finish this. Take them out. We have important things to do. We've got a kingdom to take over. And a kingdom to start. I think I have the finances at this point to really start this kingdom. I mean, things are expensive, don't get me wrong, in this game, but if I could get back every once in a while and sell my goods from the New World, I'm in really good shape. I mean, literally, it brings in 100,000 florins. And then on top of that, if I get a town, that also should bring in a fair amount of money. Fair amount of money! Oh, buddy. What are you doing?
It's your spot!
Ah, I got him. And, oh, good sidestep, my friend. Yeah, I love this new sword. You know, I'm going to keep the Sword of Horlis just, you know, for nostalgic purposes. And because it is a Sword of Horlis, and we are trying to rebuild the Calradic Empire. But, it's just not as good, you know. Things have advanced. The steel's better. We have guns now. Muskets. We must move on. I bet. Come on. Oh, what are you running away? And look at this camel rider. You're just hanging out back there? Someone take care of that man. Are we almost done? Six enemies left.
Come on, let's move on. Let's get out of here, man.
Oh, this guy wants it bad. Oh, I missed him. Well, one of my men will get him. All right, men, let's get out of here. Take a sip of my tasty beverage. All right, men, we've got important business to take care of. We only lost 4 men in that battle. That is fantastic. Oh, yeah. Okay, good. Let's release them and gain more prestige. And lots of men have been upgraded. Fantastic. Who else we have? We need all the men we can get in the coming war. I'll take a swordsman. Men at arms. Let's talk to you. Let's get this stuff first. Maybe I can give you some equipment from the plunder from the battlefield. Shouldn't even grab all of that. I really wish this mod had a function where it was easier to manage the companions. Because like most mods, you can auto upgrade and your companions automatically pick up the rest of the junk. But in this one, you really need to take care of them on an individual basis. So that can get kind of annoying over time. Let's upgrade these guys. Ooh, some Swadian knights. You know I love Swadian knights. Okay, so let's move the Swadian knight up to the top, in fact. Show these other knights how to be a proper knight. All right, let's talk to Eric Navigator. Talk about your skills. You need to bring your strength up, man. It's ridiculous. Bring your iron flesh up, and let's bring your one-handed weapons up as well. Let's talk about... Oh, I already talked about your skill. Let's talk about your equipment, not your skills. What's the best shield that I have? It appears to be this one. So you will hold on to that temporarily. Anything else? Is that better than your sword? It is not. But I'll give you this helmet. For now. Do you have gloves already? 28. You've got something already pretty good. And you've got a horse. I think you should be happy, considering you've kind of misrepresented yourself. Okay. All right. So let's see if we can escape the desert without being attacked by yet another army. And what we need to do is find... Yeah. It's been raided. I'm aware. I'll take that. I'm looking for the leader, Adenicus. The leader... Oh, here we go. Oh! Wow. I'm taking a quick save here because Adenicus is right there. I'm going to talk to Adenicus and... I need to tell him I can no longer serve the Agonic Order. Yes, yes. You never treated me well, Grandmaster. You never... treated me fairly, I must say. Yes, yes. You see, all I've done for you, and you can't help me on the Siege of Raviden. I wish to be released from my oath. Has it become burdensome? Yes, you are a burden to me, Grandmaster. I must do. Yes. Yes, I know. Yes, you can have the godforsaken village on the mountainside. I understand that. Yes, my lord. It feels good to be a free man. Enjoy your three-way war. Okay, so we are now free from the holes of the Agonic Order. And are we ready to go and siege that castle? Do we think we can do it right now? Are our men trained up enough? Oh, I don't know. The sieges are a little bit more difficult than I thought they are. I mean, the sieges in this mod are a little bit more difficult than a normal siege, especially if they sally out. Now, let's see here. I just don't want his entire army to come racing my way, because he's got over 200 men, and he's got 25 Knights of Christ. Those knights are pretty good, from what I understand. Although... I can never get one of these guys to upgrade into one. I actually don't. Oh, here you go. That's how you upgrade into one. From there. Hmm. Interesting. Well, hopefully I can get some Knights of Christ. But in the meantime, let's take a look at the possibilities of starting a kingdom up here. There's a lot of Serenids. Ooh, that's probably good for me. 88. I could probably make a run from Mirrod to Samara Castle. Ooh, I'm nervous. There's no time like the present. Ooh. Can I even siege it right out, or do I have to do something? I think I need to... That's already being raided. I think I need to actually do a formal declaration of war in some way. Maybe I just need to attack one of their men, which is probably best. Okay, I've been waiting in this desert pass, and I have found a poor lord who's going to be a lamb to the slaughter to start my new kingdom. I'm sorry, friend. I'm here to deliver my demands. I know it's surprising to you, but we're gonna have to go down, good sir. Okay, so everyone, Let's set up here. Let's bring the cavalry on me.
Bring the cavalry on me!
Let's take this man out honorably. Here they are.
Here they are.
Cavalry charge.
Who are you? I'm sorry, good sir. It had to be this way. It's a slaughter. It's a slaughter.
So we're gonna, after this, hopefully, head off to that town and try to siege it. And start our own kingdom once and for all. Our own desert kingdom. And then I believe we're going to have to go on a crusade to cleanse all the deserts of non-Christ followers. Oh.
Good job, man. Good job.
Okay, so let's get out of here. And while I was running around trying to find, let's see. It doesn't matter. Anything good? I'll take one caravan guard. While I was running around trying to find someone to actually start this war with, those are nicer than mine. Put that down here. And actually, I know some men who could use these shields and light crossbow. I'll take that as well. Well, I found out the Aghanic Order is no longer at war with the Aghanic Order. So let's see. Does that even allow me to siege a Merid? Can I do it? Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Look at this. Someone is already. It doesn't appear so. So do I have to loot a village to do this? Unbelievable. Anybody in there? Well, at least I could lure someone out. Oh, it's mine. I called it first. Take the supplies. Ooh, nice one ring. Yeah, I know. Jajar's pissed. Oh, you bastard. Looted. I have never had such a hard time trying to start a war with a damned kingdom. I have to go here? To Bashimi? Hopefully it won't happen again. Sorry, I've got a bone to pick with the Aghanic Order. Oh, look at this guy. Well, you want some? I'll take you both guys.
Both guys on, I'll take you.
Probably need to, Noble Knight. Well, he's pretty stacked. I better take him out. Better take him out now. Who are you? Never heard of you before. Yeah, you better mark it down. I'm here to deliver my demands, yes. every minor Aghanic lord, I am taking them out in this episode? Come on, men. On me. Let's find this little bastard lord. There he is. There he is with all his knights. Thinks he's so strong. I don't think so. I don't think so, sir. Knights, take him out. Who are these guys anyway? Oh, we got the high ground. We got the high ground. I don't think so. Zindar Lancers. Oh. Infantry charge in. Zindar Lancers. So he must have been part of Zindar at one point.
Come on, men.
Ah, what a cluster this is. What a cluster. Okay, so I think we've got these men pretty much. Ooh, who are you? Oh, another Lancer. Another Lancer unhorsed. Gotta take him out. Lancers everywhere! Oh, I don't mind getting off my horse. And fighting some snooty knight! Everyone, full on charge. See if I can find a knight and take him out with my musket! Get out of my way! Ah. Come on, come on, come on, come on! Get out of my way! Get out of my way! Oh, I got you, buddy. Yes! There's nothing more gratifying than shooting someone in full plate armor in this game. It's amazing. All right, load up, load up, load up, load up! Oh, buddy. Ah, terrible aim. Terrible aim. See if I can help some men up. Load it up. Load it up, Rodrick. We're almost done. I think, yeah, three enemies left. Then we'll go ahead and we'll raid that village, loot that village if we can. And hopefully we can start this war. Especially before the Aetic Order is no longer at war with anyone else. Why my troops, yes. We lost two in that? You gotta be kidding me. That's ridiculous. Release them. I don't want that guy. Let's get a few more guys upgraded here. Oh. We can probably use all of that. Let me take a quick save here as well. Let's see. All right. Can we take hostile action? Yeah, I'll take that as well. Hopefully it won't happen again. Shut up! I just don't understand. This is really strange. I'm just not quite understanding why why I can't besiege a town. I don't know what's going on. How low do I have to get with this kingdom? I have attacked multiple lords. Is he following me? Traveling, following. I see this guy. Oh, looks like he's going to take care of him for me. I'm losing money, but it just doesn't matter at this point. The only thing that matters is getting a merit. Well, guys, I don't know what's going on. Maybe you guys need to let me know in the comment section what I'm doing wrong here. And this garrison just grows and grows. It doesn't look like I'm able to besiege this town. So I'm going to go ahead and we're going to end the episode right here, guys. And I'm going to figure out what I need to do to besiege this town. I'm going to weaken the Aetic Order as much as I can in this territory. And you guys, we are taking it there. I will bring Christianity to the desert and start our desert kingdom. But guys, I want to thank you for joining me. Go ahead and hit that like button if you enjoyed this episode. If you haven't subscribed yet, guys, what are you waiting for? Go ahead and subscribe. I want to thank you for joining me, and I'll see you next time.